Everybody talks about Ted Williams, the baseball hero, and he was. But he was also a hero in a different realm, too. February of 1953, Ted Williams, Captain Ted Williams, flying an F-9, hit by artillery in the Korean War. This is all that's left of that F-9. It hit that runway at 225 miles an hour on fire, full of smoke, one wheel, and it skidded for 5,000 feet. Ted Williams escaped with his life, but he was still a hero.
Whenever I get afraid, I swear something awful. And then...
Yeah. So do we all.
Yeah, and I said, well, if there's anybody up there to help me, now's the time. I did say that in my own mind. So, the first thing I did when I got out of the plane stopped, now I'm seeing fire around me, you know? And then I jumped out and I took my helmet and I threw it as hard as I could on the ground. I'm just mad.
What were you mad
and there
at?
Was three
you
Marines been, right there.
You should have been thrilled. What were you mad at?
Just mad I had to go through all this bullshit.
He was and is a two-fisted man's man who apologizes for little in his past, but his stubbornness and arrogance cost him plenty. Three failed marriages littered his personal life.
I only regret that I couldn't make him go. I would have been with my kids more, and I could have enjoyed them more, and that's my biggest regret there.
He has lost most of his rage at the age of 76, and the love for his three children has softened him and humbled him.
Absolutely the greatest joys of my life, the greatest happiness in my life, and the proudest moments of my life. I think, what a shame. Mm.
You said, what a shame. What a shame about that? About it wish you had spent more time with them when you were younger?
That's exactly right. I wish I, but you know, here I was playing baseball.
Ted Williams was a hard man to know in his time, a loner and reluctant to trust. He turned away from people. But the one woman who knew him best, his companion for a decade, Louise Kaufman, died 2 years ago, and it deeply affects him even today.
She was a honey.
This woman, I think she was one of the only ones to talk back. You know, if you gave her hell, she'd give you hell right back.
She'd make me so damn mad sometime, and I guess everybody's experienced this, some they have to live with or are living with. And she'd make me so damn mad, I said, damn you, and she says, yeah, you go ahead and hit me, I'll kill you. It's a little fiery Scotchman, terrific gal. She really was the love of my life. Yep, she was.
The letters of awe come from everywhere. Presidents, actors, all fans of the splendid Splinter. And yet after all these years, you don't get the feeling that he was a very big fan of himself.
What's a hero? To me, you're the Duke. You're the Duke of baseball. I know John Wayne.
No,
I know you met him once.
I don't feel that at all.
You don't feel you were the John Wayne of baseball?
You know why? I know how many bad things I've done. I'm ashamed of them. And no. I think that I did some pretty good things.
But what are you ashamed of? Tell me what you're ashamed of right now on television.
I can't tell you, Christ. I mean, I'll throw you in jail. No, not really, but... I think there's very few people that have really lived a lot of life.
Oh man!
That can't say that they didn't do some things they wish they regret and wish they had never done them. And I certainly come under that category as far as I'm concerned.
In the twilight of his life, he is more at ease with who he is and what he's become. Still cranky and sarcastic at times.
All right, now that's it. Off.
He can be playful, cheerful, and charming.
And that's a little baby right there.
The legend, the icon, the rebel, the man at peace, the man at war. Ted Williams is the sum of his past, but he lives the present with gratitude and hope. Success didn't give him peace of mind. Like many of us, he's still working on happiness, but the passion always came easily. The passion to live a life, to love the game.
And your mementos will turn to dust. But that's the price you pay. For every year, the souvenir. Slowly fade.
The most important thing that ever happened to me in my life was baseball. Boy, what a game.